Hello class, welcome to yet another science lesson. In the previous lesson, we looked at smoking, drying, use of burning as the traditional methods of preserving food. Remember, we identified the foods that was preserved using smoking, and these foods were meat and fish. Under drying, that is sun drying, we identified the foods that were preserved using this method as grains, vegetables, meat, and fish. Under use of honey, we also identified the foods that were preserved using honey, and these foods are meat and rye fruits. Today, we are going to look at yet another traditional method of preserving food, and this is using low temperature. In our modern days, in our traditional days, remember we didn't have fridges. So those people needed to improvise. And here, in most cases, the foods that were preserved using low temperature were milk. Milk is a good example of food that was preserved using low temperature. The milk was got maybe from the cow, put the milk in a bottle, after which the bottle was placed inside a container of water. Then a clean material was used to cover the bottle, and remember the material was to be long, and in that it was, the edges of the material was to touch the water that was inside that container. And from what we learned in class 5 on capillary, we know that capillary is the rising of water. Since we've said that, we were to get a bottle, I'm not good in drawing. We were to get a bottle. Inside the bottle, we were to put what? Milk. And then the bottle was to be placed inside a container with water. After placing this bottle inside this container with water, then get a material, dry, clean cloth and cover the bottle, making sure that the edges of the clean cloth or material, which is cotton, retouches the water. And by so doing, the water will rise throughout the material or the fabric, making the whole fabric to be wet. And by that, the milk inside here was to remain very cold. Why am I saying that? I am saying that because as the milk should be put in a, as the water rises, this large surface area of the material will allow evaporation to take place, leaving the milk inside the bottle to be very cold. And for that, the milk will go for long without going bad. Why am I saying this? I'm saying this because the bacteria that bring about spoilage of milk, or that will enhance the milk to be to go bad, can't survive where there is very low temperature. That is all about using low temperature. This can also be illustrated using a charcoal cooler. We are going to look at another method of preserving food, and which is salting. Salting is another traditional method of preserving food. Here, what we require when preserving food is only salt. It can be unrefined salt or refined salt. What types of food can be preserved using salting? The types of food that can be preserved using salting are meat, fish, meats, and some other vegetables. Let's start with fish. We have fish. We want to preserve our fish using the salting method. What do we require? We require salt, the fish, and a box. And make sure this box has got holes at the bottom. Remember, we want to preserve fish using the salting method. We've said we need salt, the fish, and a box that has holes at the bottom. Here is our box with holes at the bottom. The first step, get the fish, remove the scales, and you also remove the offals. Remember, in our previous lessons, we identified what offals are. So I know when I say remove the offals and scales, you know what I mean. After doing so, get salt, sprinkle a layer of salt inside the box with the holes. After which, you get fish and put fish inside here. After putting the fish, assume this is the fish, after putting the fish, sprinkle another layer of salt. After doing so, add another layer of fish. You do like that alternating until the box is full. Why do we use salt? We use salt because salt will be used to drain all the water that will be inside the fish. And remember from our previous lessons, we said, for bacteria to survive, there must be water. And since we don't want our fish to go bad, we need to get rid of the bacteria by removing all the water that allows bacteria to reproduce and grow. Where, I know some of you are now asking, where does the water go to? That is why we have holes at the bottom of the box. After we put the fish inside there, remember the salt is there to dry the fish. As the water comes out of the fish, it will be going out of the box through the holes. And by so doing, the fish will remain to be very dry. And that will make us have our fish kept safely for a long time without going bad. Class, have you understood how we can preserve fish using the salting method? Very good. I know you've understood. The same will apply to meats. You can get the meats and do the same as we have done. By so doing, we will have preserved the meat using the salting method. I know some of you are asking themselves, what about vegetables? How can I preserve kale using salting method. This one applies to some vegetables, e.g., that is, for example, examples of these vegetables are French beans, green beans, green peas, and many others. These vegetables are sprinkled with salt, after which they will be sterilized and stored for future use. By so doing, we will have our fish, meats, and vegetables going for a long time without going bad. We are also going to look at another method of preserving food, and this is use of hash. We are going to look at another method of preserving food, and this one is using hash. How does hash help in preserving the food? Remember, these bacteria that bring about rotting or the food going bad do not survive where there is ash. So, after harvesting your grains, be it maize, be it cereals, what you have to do is to dry them. After drying them, remember we said there are those small pests that attack our food, making our food not to go for a long time without going to waste. Assume we have harvested maize, we have harvested beans, we have harvested green grass. And we want to keep our green grass, our maize, for a long period of time without them going to waste. What will we do? The first step we say, we can preserve them by drying. That is not enough. Because even if we dry them, we will keep off the bacteria, but we will not have kept off the pests. And in our case here, the pests are weevils, and many others. What do we do? After drying the grains, the beans, or any other cereals, get the ash, sprinkle the ash on the grains, sprinkle. Why do we do this? We do this because ash keeps off the pests such as ants and weevils. And by so doing, we can preserve the grains for a very long period of time without it going to our waste. And class, that marks the end of our lesson today.